This video tutorial I will explain CRUD operation using Spring Boot and Mongo database. Here you can see Spring Boot application. It has a book controller. Book controller talks to book service and book service talks to book repository and book repository communicates to Mongo database. And left side you can see Postman. Using a Postman client, we can send book details in a JSON format. And Spring Boot application converts the JSON format of book details to book object, and that will be passed to book controller. And book controller pass the book object to book service, and book service pass the book object to book repository, and book repository save book object into Mongo database as a JSON format. And also we will see how to get the book details and how to update the book details and how to delete the book details. CRUD stands for create, read, update and delete, and CRUD is a set of basic operations, and it is commonly used for persistent storage and manipulation of data in computer system, and it is typically within a database. C for create. The create operation is used to insert the new data to the system or add the new data to the system. In a database context, inserting new record or entity into a table or a collection. R for read. Read operation is used to retrieve or fetch existing data from the system. In a database context, it involves querying and fetching specific records or entities from the table or a collection. U for update. Update operation is used to modify or update existing data in a system. In a database context, it involves changing the values of specific fields or properties of a record or entity in a table or a collection. And D for delete. Delete operation is used to remove or delete existing data from the system. In a database context, it involves deleting specific records or entities from a table or collection. In the context of web development, CRUD operations are often implemented through HTTP methods. For creating new resource, we have to use HTTP POST method. For get the resource or retrieve the resource, we have to use HTTP GET method. To update an existing resource, we have to use HTTP PUT method or patch method. To remove resource, we have to use HTTP DELETE method. And CRUD operations are widely used in database systems, web applications, APIs and other software systems for data management and manipulation. Here you can see MongoDB demo project and its folder structure. Now we will see what and all steps which are involved in Spring Boot and Mongo database connectivity. The step one is we have to include necessary dependencies in Spring Boot project's pom.xml file, and there are two dependencies we have to add. The first one is Spring Boot starter data MongoDB, and the second one is Spring Boot starter web. Here you can see the pom.xml file, and here you can see the dependencies which we have discussed. The step 2 is configure Mongo database connection. In Spring Boot project's application.property file, we have to specify Mongo database connection details. And here you can see the host is localhost and port number is 27017, which is default port of Mongo database, and database name is bookstore. There are some important parameters that we need to know to connect to the Mongo database server with Spring Boot. The first one is port number. By default, port number is 27017. And the second one is host. By default, host name is localhost. Then the third one is database name. And the fourth one is credential. Credential is optional. If Mongo database server configured with username and password, then we have to provide. Otherwise, the credential is optional. and in application.properties file, we have to set this key value pairs to connect to the Mongo database, or we have to use this key value pair to connect to the Mongo database. Spring.data.mongodb.uri equal to MongoDB, then username and password and host name, then port number slash database name, which is bookstore. And if username and password is not there, then we can do like this: MongoDB, localhost, then the port number, then the database name. By default, we no need to provide the username and password. Here you can see application.properties file, and here you can see MongoDB connection properties. The step 3 is create a MongoDB entity, and we have to define MongoDB entity class that represents document in your MongoDB collection, and we have to annotate the class with @document and define the fields and their mappings. You have to keep in mind that your class name will be your collection name and the variable will be column name when it will create in your database. And here you can see the class book, and I have annotated with @document, and it has three attributes: book ID, book name and author name. Here you can see the class book. The step 4 is define MongoDB repository. We have to create a MongoDB repository interface by extending Mongo repository interface, which is provided by Spring Data MongoDB. And with the help of this interface, we can perform CRUD operations in our database. Here I have defined the interface book repository and annotated with @repository, which extends Mongo repository interface. Here I have given a book, which is the class which we have seen, and string is nothing but data type of book ID, and for that book ID we have annotated with @ID. So this book ID will be auto generated. Here I have defined the book repository interface, which extends Mongo repository interface, and here you can define custom queries, or you can use default CRUD operations provided by Mongo repository. The step 5 is use MongoDB repository. We have to inject MongoDB repository into Spring Boot service class and use it to perform database operations. And here you can see I have defined book service class, which is service class, and here I have injected book repository object, and it has methods to perform CRUD operations. Here I have defined the class book service, which is service class, and here I have auto-add book repository object, and here you can see the methods to perform save the book details, get the book details, update the book details, delete the book details, and get all the books. The step 6 is define controller class, which uses service class. We will create controller class. From there, we will perform a CRUD operation in our database. And here I have defined the book controller class and annotated with REST controller. And here I have auto-wired book service object. Here I have defined the class book controller, which is REST controller. Here I have auto-wired book service object. And this class has methods to perform CRUD operations. And to call this method, we have to use a post method, and the path should be save book. And here we are calling save book method of book service object and passing the book object. And to call this get book method, we have to use this path, and HTTP method should be get. To call update book method, we have to use this path, and HTTP method should be put. To call delete book method, we have to use this path, and HTTP method should be delete. and to call getAllBook method, we have to use this path, and HTTP method should be get. Here I have defined the class MongoDB demo application, which is a Spring Boot application. Now I am going to run this Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application has been started, and it is started in 8080 port. I have started the Spring Boot application, which connects to Mongo database, and using Postman client, we will create the book details, update the book details, get the book details, and delete the book details. Here you can see the databases which are available now, and if you see, the bookstore database is not available. Now I am going to create the book details. For that URL is this one, and HTTP method is post, and in the body we have to select raw data type, and here we have to select JSON. Click on send, and here you can see the book details is successfully created. Book ID is the random generated number, and book name is Java Tutorial, author name is Ramyan. Click on refresh, and here you can see bookstore database is created. In that book collection is created, and it has one book. Now we will create one more book details. Click on send, and here we got the response, and the book detail is created. Click on refresh, and here you can see there are two book details are there. To get the particular book details, we have to copy this book ID, which is unique for the particular book, and we have to use this URL, and here we have to provide the book ID. HTTP method should be get. Click on send, and here we got the book details. And to update the particular book, we have to use this URL, and here we have to give the unique ID. Book name and author name I have given new names, and HTTP method should be put. Click on send, and book details is updated. And if you want to delete the particular book details, we have to use this URL. HTTP method should be delete, and here we have to provide the unique book ID. Click on send, and the book details is deleted successfully. Click on refresh, and here you can see the book details is deleted successfully. I will create one more book, and I will create one more book. Now total three books are there. To get all the books, we have to use this URL. HTTP method should be get. Click on send, and here we got all the books details in the array.
You can get a Java source code link for each video from the description section of the video. And here you can see the video. And to see the description, click on this more. And here you can see the description. And here you can see the links. And click on these links to get the Java source code.